Hello and welcome to a new series of lectures, which I'd like to call Jewish Heroes and Heroism. And the reason for this series is because I'm preparing for a new set of lectures to go along with another cruise. This time, the cruise with Kosher Riverboat Cruises, as always, is going to be on the Seine River, which I'm especially looking forward to. And because we will be specifically looking at Normandy and focusing on D-Day and events of the First and Second World Wars, this whole series, which I hope to release once a month or so, is going to be on a few select individuals who I think exemplify certain aspects of Jewish heroes and Jewish heroism. Just to look at the cruise itself, this is going to be so fantastic. I love these cruises. We're going to visit the Seine River. We're going to start here in Paris, and then we're going to make our way up to the northwest, following the Seine River, out to Normandy and the region of Le Havre. I'm especially looking forward to seeing Rouen, which has been recently featured in some archaeological studies because we found very old evidence of a medieval Jewish community in the Rouen, and that's going to be absolutely fascinating. But let's go to our topic at hand. Since we are entering the month of Kislev, and we want to talk about heroism, it seems obvious that we should speak about Yehuda Maccabee, one of the most remarkable heroes and military campaigners of all of Jewish history. And I specifically want to look at one battle in particular, the Battle of Emmaus, which in many ways is characteristic of the kind of military thinking and strategy that Judah brought to the field. So just to place this in context, we are of course speaking about the great Hanukkah rebellion, which broke out about the year 167 before the Common Era. It's often, especially in primary school, portrayed as a war against the Seleucid Greeks, that is the successor kingdom to Alexander the Great's empire, but it really was a civil war in which Jewish Hellenizers, that is those Jews living in Israel who really wanted to assimilate to Greek norms, were leading a charge to try and make Jewish culture much more like general Greek culture and get rid of all of those fanaticism and things like that are associated with the old timers. This led to, and the great examples of that are the high priest Menelaus, who was quite a mendacious and dislikable character in many ways, who ended up getting the position of high priest, a highly corrupt position at the time, largely sponsored by the Greek emperor Antiochus Epiphanes IV. They faced a dramatic grassroots rebellion led by Mattathiah and his sons, who are known as the Maccabees. After Mattathiah died, the leadership clearly went to Yehuda Maccabee, who, as we shall see, was an especially talented military thinker. So let's look at this specific battle that is in the context of the civil war with a lot of major support from the Syrian Greeks. So here we are in the year 166 before the Common Era. The battle was at Emmaus, very important city also in Christian thought as well. And General Lysias comes down here at the behest of the Emperor Antiochus with 40,000 well-armed professional troops with 7,000 horsemen. And it's an incredibly large force to bring to bear here. It is so overwhelming in nature because he's facing essentially a guerrilla revolt by peasants that slave traders from all around the region began to descend on Israel because they anticipated there would be a lot of people to buy and then sell on the trade on the slave market. By the way, much of this information comes from the Book of Maccabees, which was not included in the traditional Jewish Tanakh. It's considered one of the Sefer Chitzonim, one of the outside books known as the Apocrypha, that is ironically included in the Christian Bible for reasons which are too complex for us here. But the first Book of Maccabees was likely written by someone who actually saw the events firsthand. At any rate, the forces under Judah gathered at Mitzpah, not too far away, about 3,000 volunteer peasant fighters, very poorly equipped, no match at all for this professional army. But the description in the first book of Maccabees is fascinating. When they realized that they were going to be attacked by such a large and professional force, they fasted, they put on sackcloth, they specifically went and looked at the Torah for guidance, what should we be doing, and in fact they followed the the dictates that are laid down in the book of Deuteronomy to the letter, dismissing anyone who wanted to fight if they had been married within the previous year, or if they had just planted a vineyard, or even if they were afraid, they were dismissed. And with this preparation, Judah went into battle, which is one of the reasons why I think he's such a tremendous hero, because of his ideological purity combined with his heroism that would not always stand him in his good stead, as we shall see in a moment. At any rate, here's a map of the actual Battle of Emmaus. It starts out when one of the local commanders, Gordias, takes 5,000 troops and 1,000 horses from the larger camp in Emmaus, and he takes them out in a rapid forced march overnight, hoping to attack Yehuda before they can flee to the hills. They fully anticipate that this is going to be just a cleanup operation. They want to take care of it, as efficiently as possible. You can see from the kind of dotted lines that that's the path that the Gorgias and his troops took. When Judah heard about this, rather than scattering, going to the hills, which is sort of like the go-to move of rebels in this region, or the caves later we would see with the Bar Kokhba rebels, instead, Judah makes a very bold move and he counterattacks. He actually moves to the south and avoids Gorgias' army, and he actually attacks the main camp at dawn. An incredibly bold and, if I can use the Hebrew term, chutzpahdik move. The camp is completely surprised by Judah's bold attack, and they are defeated, and the camp is set on fire, and the vast majority of those who survive simply flee. But Judah does not direct his troops to pursue the fleeing base camp. Instead, he orders them to remain and to stay in hiding for Gorgias to return. When Gorgias comes back and he finds that his camp is in flames, that's when Judah surprise attacks again and completely throws them into confusion, and it's a complete victory for the Maccabees. A really dramatic turnaround for a poorly equipped, vastly outnumbered force. And this kind of strategic thinking is something that we will see characteristic of Jewish heroism over the ages. Now, there's a lot more to say about the Hanukkah Rebellion. It was not a one-battle war. There were many battles, some of which were definitely reversals for the Maccabees, and I have discussed these in some degree elsewhere. But I think in terms of Judah Maccabee, one of the things that we should reflect upon is that although he had this like laser-like focus on the task ahead, and he was a brilliant commander, he proved unable to adapt to the end of the war, when a lot of the victors, the Jewish victors, thought that, okay, this is the time where we should compromise and we should like make peace. He seemed unwilling to do so. And in fact, he continued the war even after the majority of his loyalists had abandoned him, and he ultimately fell in battle. But nevertheless, a phenomenal example of Jewish heroism. I hope you found this little video useful, and I would love to see you on this cruise on the Seine, where we're going to speak a lot more about this kind of history. Thank you very much for watching.